to walk around on the stage, so I need this. I'd like to introduce myself. My name's Gary Whiteson. I'm the director of PELAC Autism Services, the incredible organization that Gary Pastore embraced with all his heart and supported wholeheartedly. A little bit about me. My wife and I have 8 children. That's right, 8 children. My son Christopher is 20 years old, and Chris has autism. When Chris was born 20 years ago, the rate of autism was 1 in 5,000. Today, the rate of autism in the state of New Jersey is 1 in 45. 1 out of every 45 children born in the state of New Jersey has autism. You take AIDS, cancer, diabetes, cystic fibrosis, Down syndrome, muscular dystrophy, combine those 6, more children have autism than those 6 combined. We don't know what causes autism yet, but we're working on finding a cure, finding ways to help our children. But the good news is, once we get our children diagnosed, we know how to help them. And we're doing incredible things. Our organization, PELAC, started with 4 parents around a kitchen table in Bricktown, right up the road from here, and has grown to the largest provider of autism training, education, and recreation in the entire state of New Jersey. Last year alone, we had 244 events that a parent could have taken their child to or a teacher could have gone to for free. Yesterday, if I look a little red, yesterday we actually took 250 autistic kids and their siblings and we taught them how to surf over at Seaside. And we do that every year. That's an incredible day. Incredible day. There are challenges with children with autism. Our son's a gift to both my wife and I, and we were thankful every day with him. But there are challenges, and safety is a real issue. I'm a certified law enforcement instructor. I've trained police all across the state, 17,000 in New Jersey. The leading cause of death for children with autism is drowning, because many of our kids wander off, and they're usually, you know, very often we'll find up in the ocean or a river or a pool. We started a program called our Autism Shield Program 7 years ago, and we trained 17,000 officers and 10,000 firefighters and thousands of EMTs. That program has been credited with saving so many children's lives with autism that somewhere along the line we lost track on how many kids we saved, where the police chief would call us up and said this child would have been dead if not for PELAC. That story is what touched Gary. And when he came to our gala this past February, he heard that, met so many of our kids that came to our gala, fell in love with the organization, and decided to make PELAC his charity of choice and use all that money. Yeah, Gary, just look. All of the money donated to PELAC tonight goes 100% to the Autism Shield program. I mentioned we're the largest provider in the state. We're not funded by the state. We don't get one penny from the government. We get all our money from people like you that come out and support us. And we're at 95.5 cents that every dollar goes to children. So before I start the film, because we had a lot of issues and a lot of stats, I always like to tell an autism story, a funny one. And I got a bunch when I went to Select One. I love this theater. I actually grew up in Lakewood, not that far from here. I grew up coming to the Strand, and it always reminded me of going to church. And my favorite autism story is a church story involving my son, Chris. Now, Chris, at 20, he doesn't shut the heck up, but at 4 years old, he didn't say a single word. Not one. He didn't speak a single word at 4. And at 5 years old, Christopher only knew 3 words, and they were rooster, ketchup, and no. Not the best words in the world, but we were really, really proud to have him have 3 words. So it's Easter, and I'm taking the kids to church. Chris is 5 years old, his brother Matthew's 3, and my baby girl is 1. And I'm late, as always, for church, and I get there, and the church is packed, except the front pew. The front pew is empty. Everybody of other seat in the house is packed. So I'm perfectly content to stay in the back of the church, but the usher's doing this thing to me. Come on up. I'm like, no. I'm fine right here, please. And he's doing this. It got so uncomfortable that I'm like, all right, I have to walk the green mile to the front pew. And I got to the front pew, and I'm saying a prayer to God. I figured I'm in church. He has to listen to me. He has to. So I'm like, God, please let Chris be good. Please let him be good. So we're getting in the front pew, and I got the three kids with me, and I got the Christopher Be Good bag, you know, all those treats that he likes. You know, that was the parents of autistic kids that laughed at that. And we're Catholic church, and usually our services are kind of, I don't use the word boring, you know, but I check my watch sometimes as like near the hour. But this week we had a visiting priest, and he was like an evangelical priest. And he was one of the fire and brimstone type priests. And he got up there and he said, you have to ask yourself, are you willing to put God before your family? And Christopher jumps up in the front pew and screams at the loud top of his voice, no way! Priest goes on, are you willing to put God before your job? Chris, no way! Well, the priest asked like five questions, and Christopher's response was the same each time, no way, and the church was laughing. And I'm rubbing Christopher's back, saying, good talking, Chris, good talking. Because I think I'm going to hell for allowing my son to heckle the priest. But you have to realize, that was the first time my son said two words together, ever. And he has come through the help of POAC, from that little boy screaming no way in the front pew of a church, to the amazing 20-year-old man he is today. And I can guarantee you, with the support of you, a year from now, my son will be better than he is today. Me, not so much. But I can guarantee you, my son will be. Thank you to Gary. Incredible film. You guys are in for a treat. And without further delay on my part, I would like to open the blinds and intro De-Stressed. Thank you.